That stole the weasel. The Fox 31 problem solvers investigate what happened to this rare World War II vehicle that seems to have vanished without a trace.
That's where we start at 5:30. A World War II vehicle collector traveling through Colorado had his prized M29 cargo carrier stolen at the hotel where he was staying, and this was on it.
Fox 31 problem solver Dan DeRue, no stranger to World War II vehicles himself, trying to help locate this rare piece of American history. Dan?
It is a small, tracked World War II vehicle. The nickname is the Weasel, and it should not be hard to spot with your help, that is.
It proved its ruggedness and adaptability under almost all conditions of winter operation.
Of the 15,892 World War II tracked vehicles nicknamed the Weasel, Bryant Breaux had to have one.
The intention was to take it back to Georgia and get it running, get it painted, get it back on the road to tell the story of the history of World War II.
Bro traveled to Orem, Utah and bought this one, then headed home to Winston, Georgia.
We can use our work, our labor, our resources to get these pieces of history back on the road to keep people educated about the sacrifice of the greatest generation.
Bro stopped in Aurora for an overnight rest.
On his way back to Georgia, Bro stopped here at the Econo Lodge, parked his truck with the trailer behind, went inside to get some shut-eye.
At around 2:20 in the morning, car thieves likely targeting Bro's F-250 truck broke in, started the engine, and drove off with the flatbed trailer and the World War II Weasel in tow.
I mean, we're a little dejected. It was one of the last 2 days of the trip, but I think it is a lot of shock.
Bro has every right to be upset. The Weasel is a fairly rare and collectible vehicle.
At the end of the war, we used them kind of during Korea, but after that, we got bigger and better things, and what do you do with stuff like that? You kind of just ditch it. A lot of them turned into probably beer cans or razor blades.
Problem solvers need your help in finding the Weasel. It may have a camo paint job, but this rig is hard to hide. So if you see it anywhere, call the cops.
Being that they are so rare, if you try to sell it, all the military vehicle collectors are gonna know where it is.
Help us save this piece of American history and keep it out of the scrapyard.
Absolutely. Now, the F-250, the Ford F-250, had Georgia plates, but the flatbed trailer had Colorado plates. If you see the Weasel on or off the trailer, call the cops. Dan DeRue, Fox 31.
Yeah, hard to miss. Dan, thank you. Following up on some breaking news from the top.